Greetings, magnificent souls, to the Attract Health, Build Wealth podcast, where we have open and honest discussions about ourselves. This is a place where we break down, break away, and break through codependency, allowing ourselves to attract health, build wealth, and live a peaceful life. We are tired of being sick and tired. We are tired, but we are not giving up. We know that there is something magnificent inside of us. And because we are fighting daily, hourly, and by the minute, fighting ourselves, our kids, our spouses, we have to do things differently. We have to break the cycle. We don't have a million chances. We have to be happy now. We have to find a way. So how do we do that? How is that possible? If you look around at what society is telling you, they tell you that what we're doing is impossible, yet it's happening every single day. And it's happening through the practice and the love that we call awakening the magnificent soul. We are all magnificent souls, and these are our stories of healing. Today in episode 15, we are talking today about codependency and quote unquote women's work or women's roles and how I saw this playing out in my life and in the past and, to be honest, sometimes even today. So I have to constantly check myself. But before we get into the discussion, don't forget to let me know your thoughts about this episode, any feedback you have, or anything you'd like me to cover on future podcasts at epiphanyvault.com. Remember, you can share anonymously. It is a safe place, and I would welcome the discussion. And as with everything here at Attract Health, Build Wealth, the inspiration for this discussion came directly from my experience, my reflections, my past struggles, and sometimes even my daily struggles as I work to define myself, to retune myself to my frequency. My reflections have led me here to this topic as I make sense of my reactions to people and certain situations. So I began thinking about women's roles and about women's work, so to speak, as I look at society and recent hot button topics. It's no wonder that so many women are suffering from codependency. Mind you, codependency does not discriminate. I know men out there suffer as well, but the way that society projects women's roles can be a catalyst to that. So let's dive in a little bit. First, why do we talk about this? As you all know, I've been doing a lot of introspection about my codependent behaviors, and I was thinking one day about women's roles in general, like women's roles in society, which got me thinking about professional roles like glass ceilings, the hashtag MeToo movement, and other kind of offshoots of the women's perspective. But specifically, I want to talk today about a woman's role in the household and family and how it might relate and have some similarities to codependency. In my view, it's important to call this out because I think knowledge only brings strength. And depending on where you are in your codependency journey, when you can recognize those tendencies, we can begin to relearn healthier roles within our relationship. And from what relationships? And from what I can gather, there are a lot of women and men out there suffering from codependency. In addition to that, and I don't have any empirical evidence on this, but I'm sure it's out there, but my guess is that there are more women than men. I think the reason for this is the societal pressures placed on women in the home. The caveat here is that men with codependency typically are afflicted in the same way as women. And to me, that makes sense because homes that normally breed codependence are fraught with neglect, absence, abuse, or difficulty with varying degrees in systems. And that definitely does not discriminate. And many people can get embroiled into the caretaking role and thereby become disconnected from oneself. But in my opinion, the overarching role of women in our society and our households, coupled with adverse childhood experiences, codependent familiar patterns and familial, patterns can create a perfect storm when it comes to codependent and its adaptations by women. And these adaptations look like a lot of things, a lot of what we talk about here and now and what we will talk about. Things like lopsided relationships where the scales are not equal, which is a convoluted equation with many different facets because it is emotional, intellectual, physical, spiritual, and sexual. It looks like enabling others, whether that be partners, children, mom, dad, etc. It could be protecting, rescuing, salvaging others, thereby making it impossible for them to reap the results of their actions. And here's the big one for me, which is putting all resources in all categories. We're talking emotional, intellectual, physical, spiritual, sexual, financial, towards an outcome. And quote unquote, ought to, should, or will, or some sort of future result. Or if you're putting all your energy in the past, like if only this would have happened when you're thinking about something in the past. Seriously, how many times have you said to yourself, if I do this, then he or she will fill in the blank? And if you're like me, that happens a lot. So my thoughts lead to this. How did my Southern upbringing in general lead me on a codependent path? In general, my role as I was younger and even as of, I would say, a couple years ago, was to be quiet and smile. I heard many times in my childhood, if it's not nice, don't say anything at all, which is a common thing. And in retrospect, that completely ignores any of my emotions, my thoughts, or my feelings that I could have. It's like saying there is no negativity in the world or just to completely ignore it, to which I say now is really unhealthy. And it's okay to recognize pain and hurt and negativity. In fact, I think it's one of the tenets of remaining in the now is that you can be present with unhappiness, but it doesn't have to define you. And women are typically caretakers too. And we all know the housewife stereotype that has defined women's household roles for a really long time. And although some would argue that there is a paradigm shift when it comes to that, in my experience, this is a founding pillar when it comes to women's work, quote unquote, and even today. We're expected to put others first. We always have been. And the mothers that I talk to presently feel guilty about taking time for themselves and prioritizing their well-being. Disregarding wants and needs and sacrifice to their families, their husbands, children, elderly parents, etc., is what, quote unquote, a good woman does. And the pressures of being a good woman, are astronomical. Yet these roles are continually perpetuated. In most women's lives, while juggling a career, this is their life's definition. And let me just say this too. I don't want to demean caretaking roles. And in my view, there's nothing wrong at all with caretaking for a family because I know it's such a rewarding, enriching, loving, fulfilling human dynamic and experience for sure. But what we're talking about here is the unbalancing effect of these actions and roles can have on someone. These expectations are so heavy and pervasive. Women tend to have a lot of pressure on them from society, more so from themselves, to self-sacrifice and become a martyr in pursuit of overly caring for others. The resulting disconnect from self is the phenomenon we call codependency. And for women that are embroiled in this, we take this to the extreme. We take on all of these roles and values from a toxic mix of society and our family of origin, all just trying to be a quote unquote good mom, wife, daughter, member of society. We are, after all, being loyal to our family. Let me just stop here and say, if this is you, it's okay. Trust me, it's me too, and it has been me. And again, it's not my intention here today to categorize you or me, my actions or your actions as good or bad. In fact, I'm trying to step away from the categorizations because I believe those categorizations are an outward projection to you, on you. But it's my hope that I might be inspiring you, if any of this is touching you, to take an introspective look at your life if you're feeling out of balance, and maybe to think about how any of these gender roles as it pertains to quote-unquote women's work might be affecting you. And what do you think about all this? Do you see women's work playing out in your life? I would really like to hear from you at epiphanyvault.com, and I will see you next time. Living and loving.